Hey guys, I'm John and welcome to Respect Your Intellect. We may have detected the first observation of a black hole swallowing a neutron star through gravitational waves. So let's talk about why we still need to confirm it and what this discovery could reveal about the interactions between the densest objects in the universe. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons and let's get started. The LIGO and Virgo collaboration is a scientific collaboration of international physics institutes and research groups dedicated to the search for gravitational waves. Gravitational waves are disturbances in the fabric of space-time that travel at the speed of light, and they're generated by massive bodies when they're accelerated or disturbed. Members of the collaboration have access to both US-based LIGO detectors in Hanford, Washington and Livingston, Louisiana. They also have access to the Virgo detector in Pisa, Italy, and the GEO 600 detector in Sarstedt, Germany. Throughout all the institutions and research groups involved, there are about 1,200 scientists in total. The collaboration was successful in finding the first gravitational waves on September 14, 2015, and have since won many awards for their achievements. In 2016, they won the Special Breakthrough Prize in Fundamental Physics, the Gruber Prize in Cosmology, and the Enrico Fermi Prize. In 2017, they won the Bruno Rossi Prize, the Albert Einstein Medal, and the Princess of Asturias Award. On April 1st, 2019, they started their new observing run called O3 that's planned to last a whole year, and it's twice as sensitive as the previous run. On April 25th, 2019, they found a cataclysmic merger of two neutron stars for only the second time. This happened about 500 million light years from Earth. The problem with this detection is that only one of the two LIGO facilities picked up the signal, along with Virgo. So with only two out of the three LIGO Virgo detectors having picked up the signal, it makes the location of the source uncertain. It's currently only narrowed down to a quarter of the sky, which is an extremely large region. Since it could take a long time to confirm this one by finding the source, we're going to talk about the next signal they found. On April 26, 2019, just one day after the detection of the merging neutron stars, all three facilities picked up the signal from a neutron star and black hole collision. This event is estimated to have taken place about 1.2 billion light years from Earth. Since all three facilities picked up the signal, we were able to reduce the uncertainty a lot more than the signal from the two neutron stars colliding. Instead of narrowing down to 25% of the sky, this time it was narrowed down to 3% of the sky. It's still a large region to look through though, so it might take a bit of time to confirm. Here's what Professor Alberto Vecchio, head of astrophysics and space research at the University of Birmingham, and director of the Institute of Gravitational Wave Astronomy, had to say about it. All the astronomers are now chasing an unfortunately enormous patch of the sky to see whether there's some light that has switched on at that time. Collisions like these latest ones also send out radiation when energy is released during the collision, so it's visible in many different wavelengths as well. David Reitz, who's a research professor of physics at Caltech and executive director of LIGO, said, "The latest LIGO-Virgo observing run is proving to be the most exciting one so far. We're already seeing hints of the first observation of a black hole swallowing a neutron star. If it holds up, this would be a trifecta for LIGO and Virgo. In 3 years, we'll have observed every type of black hole and neutron star collision." He also said, "We're especially curious about the April 26 candidate. Unfortunately, the signal is rather weak. It's like listening to somebody whisper a word in a busy cafe. It can be difficult to make out the word or even to be sure that the person whispered at all. It will take some time to reach a conclusion about this candidate." The researchers estimate the chance of it being a glitch at around 14%, leaving an 86% chance that the event happened. This isn't a given just yet, but it's good enough to announce the possibility before the confirmation. So let's talk a bit about neutron stars and black holes. Neutron stars are the most massive stars, and also the smallest, meaning that they're also the most dense. The only thing more dense than a neutron star is a black hole. Neutron stars form during some supernova explosions when giant stars die, so they're considered supernova remnants. Dying stars that are too massive to form a neutron star can form black holes instead. Neutron stars are made up of tightly packed neutrons, so it's like a 12-mile-wide atomic nucleus on average. It's actually even denser than atomic nuclei by 10 to 100 times the mass, since neutrons are a bit more massive than protons. Just the outer crust of the neutron star has neutrons packed so tight that it's about 10 billion times stronger than steel. About 1 teaspoon of neutron star material has a mass of about 5.5 billion tons, which is about 900 times the Great Pyramid of Giza, all in just 1 teaspoon of material. If the entire Earth were as dense as a neutron star, it wouldn't be 12,000 kilometers in diameter, it would be about 305 meters. If we forget about the crazy gravitational pull, this would be about the size where you could go from one pole to the other pole in a 5-minute walk. As for black holes, contrary to what your intuition might tell you, the bigger they are, the less dense they are. This means that the gravitational pull near the threshold of the black hole would be less intense and might allow a neutron star to simply disappear instead of being ripped apart. Vecchio said, "The neutron star would just dive in and nothing happens, that's it." With smaller black holes and a much more fierce gravitational pull at the event horizon, they could potentially rip apart neutron stars and swallow them in multiple big chunks instead. On this, Vecchio said, "Then you'd have this extremely dense material traveling at a fraction of the speed of light." He also said it could release spectacular blasts of radiation that could be spotted by telescopes on Earth. If this all turns out to be confirmed and to be true, it would be the first evidence that black holes and neutron stars can pair up in binary systems. It could reveal many new details about whether the neutron star was ripped apart into chunks before getting to the event horizon, or if it went in with its full mass and just disappeared. This could even reveal new things about how black holes behave and interact with other massive objects. Since LIGO started observing in 2015, its sensitivity has increased significantly and it's now able to make several detections every single month. This could even help find some of the more exotic objects that are theorized but not yet observed, like boson stars or mini black holes. Patrick Brady, who's a professor of physics at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee and spokesman for the LIGO collaboration, said, "We're opening a new window on the universe, and this will hopefully bring us a whole new perspective on what's out there." I want to thank my patrons on Patreon that help support the channel. I really appreciate the support. My Discord server is also currently open to the public and we're starting to get some interesting discussions going on, so if you're interested in joining us and coming for a chat, check the description for the invite link. If you'd like to learn more interesting science stuff, make sure to like, subscribe, and click the bell notification. If you'd like to help support the channel, you can visit my Patreon page for more information. For everything else, you can go to respectyourintellect.com and everything will be available there. Until next time, thanks for watching, and remember, respect your intellect.